Well, today I'm going to be taking Rich Lee, who's the editor of Angling Times, out to do some lure fishing in my new boat. Here it is, the good ship Lollipop. And as you can see, it's pretty well kitted out for freshwater sport type fishing, both with flies and with lures. Got a large casting space at the front, a flat deck, and then dotted around the boat, lots of nice little features that make it good for lure fishing. But today, it's not going to be very easy at all. The water's really cold, and you can probably tell by the amount of ice in this slack water behind me in the marina that I'm going to have my work cut out today. The water temperature's just over. Well, today I'm going to be taking Rich Lee, who's the editor of Angling Times, out to do some lure fishing in my new boat. Here it is, the good ship Lollipop. And as you can see, it's pretty well kitted out for freshwater sport type fishing, both with flies and with lures. Got a large casting space at the front, a flat deck, and then dotted around the boat, lots of nice little features that make it good for lure fishing. But today, it's not going to be very easy at all. The water's really cold, and you can probably tell by the amount of ice in this slack water behind me in the marina that I'm going to have my work cut out today. The water temperature's just over 2 degrees. So I've got a plan. I'm going to take the boat down to Tewkesbury, and I'm going to try and work lures as slowly as possible in fairly deep water, and I'll be looking for cover and structure. Whirlpools, moored boats, slack water near to trees, that sort of thing. Anywhere that will hold fish in these freezing cold conditions. Well, today I'm going to be taking Rich Lee, who's the editor of Angling Times, out to do some lure fishing in my new boat. Here it is, the good ship Lollipop. And as you can see, it's pretty well kitted out for freshwater sport type fishing, both with flies and with lures. Got a large casting space at the front, a flat deck, and then dotted around the boat, lots of nice little features that make it good for lure fishing. But today, it's not going to be very easy at all. The water's really cold, and you can probably tell by the amount of ice in this slack water behind me in the marina that I'm going to have my work cut out today. The water temperature's just over 2 degrees. So I've got a plan. I'm going to take the boat down to Tewkesbury, and I'm going to try and work lures as slowly as possible in fairly deep water, and I'll be looking for cover and structure. Whirlpools, moored boats, slack water near to trees, that sort of thing. Anywhere that will hold fish in these freezing cold conditions. But with any luck, we might even catch something. Well, this is a salmon Kelton. Ordinarily, I'd release this fish in the water, but obviously you want to have a look at it. And if I can tail the fish, I don't want to damage it in any way, because it's got an important job in nature to do. But let's see if I can just get its tail. As you can see, it's not at all happy with me. Not surprisingly, really. There they are. Calm down. Okay, now, basically this is a salmon that's spawned and is getting ready to go back to sea. Can you see how thin it is? Very, very thin. Let's put it on this unhooking mat and look at a few of the features. How do we know it's a Kelton, not a fresh fish? Well, by its overall condition, we can see here a little bit of coloration on the gills. It's begun to take on its sea colours again. It's gone from a darker colour, it's going silver. This is a fish that has spawned and it's now swimming back downstream to go back to sea, where it will recommence feeding and come back to spawn again, probably as a very, very big fish. The vent of the fish here is open, and that's because basically this fish has spawned, all of its eggs have been deposited on the riverbed, and it's done its job. First time that I've had the chance to use this little baby lure rod, and it's one of the Fox Rage rods. It's really, really nice. It's rated for quite small lures, up to 10 grams, which is a third of an ounce. So it's designed for ultralight stuff. And what I've done is I've coupled it with some light braid. This is 6 kilo Fox braid. Again, really good stuff. First time I've used it. And I'm using it to work small lures. I will do some plastic lure fishing. This is quite an unusual little lure that's great in slack water. It's called a rattling plug. And this is an American one by probably Cut and Cadell, I think, or maybe a Bill Lewis. And anyway, it's got some ball bearings inside it. So inside that hollow chamber, the bearings rattle. And these lures sink, so there's lots of ways you can retrieve them. We cast it out, count it down, 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, 5,000. A stringer needle. So it's a stringer for a stinger. And you can see that that's the one that's hooked the fish. Very subtle presentation. Well, I've just hooked a fish right underneath the boat, and that's a really nice Zander, this. I don't want this one to come off. In fact, I think I might have to net it. But it may just be on the stinger. There it is. Oh, that's a That's a big Zander. I think I managed to hook it before it really realised it was hooked. It just came looming up, and I was expecting a perch or something. I've never hooked a big Zander before in this place, but I can tell you that's definitely a double. It's a really, really nice fish. Well, this is a great way to christen my baby lure rod. Just 11 pounds and 9 ounces. Really, really nice Zander. And I'm just going to lower it over the side now. Hold it by the tail. Oh, well, there was no problem with that fish going back. It was really, really aggressive. Great experience, and you know, catching the fish on ultralight tackle like that is really, really good fun. And it's actually a very efficient way because you've got very little danger of the hook pulling out with a nice light rod like that one. Just goes to show that sometimes when it's really cold, subtlety is the way forward. Okay, what I'm going to do now is show you how to rig one of these Fox Rage stinger trebles, which can make the difference sometimes between hooking a shy biting fish and not hooking it. So I've got one of the Fox Rage shads here. It's quite an unusual shape, this, but it's one that I've found that perch and zander particularly seem to like. So basically I'm going to go in using this stringer needle down through the body of the fish, bringing the needle out into this belly slit area here, and then I'm going to hook on the stinger. Now they do these in tough fluorocarbon and wire. I've never been bitten off. I'm happy to use the fluorocarbon ones. That's very much the continental way, but if you want to use wire, they do them in wire as well. So basically I've now got the stinger wired through the soft plastic lure, and now I'm just going to put my jig head on. This is quite a light jig head because I'm fishing shallow water here. So there's my jig head, and then I'm going to attach the little loop on the stinger over the eye, and there I am rigged. Stinger sitting just at the back of the lure, jig hook at the front. Not good when you're in snaggy water because it increases your chance of basically snagging the bottom, but when you're in open water and you've got shy biting fish like zander and perch, the stinger system's really, really good. Really beautiful, brightly coloured perch. Look at that. Really fat as well, as they are at this time of year. Beautiful fish. Ooh, that's a gorgeous perch. Fantastic colours. Really cold water, and this fish is bristling. Absolutely pristine. That's beautiful. Well, that was a take actually on the drop before I'd started to jig with a lure, and you know, that happens quite a lot. The main reason for using ultralight braid, small lures, really sensitive equipment in these cold conditions is that the bites can be very, very subtle indeed, and even big pike occasionally will give a subtle bite. This isn't a big fish, it's just a small zander, but it illustrates the point nicely. And yet again, because of the cold conditions, I'm using the stinger rig just to make sure I nail them. Oh yes, got it. Ah, oh, that's a bit of fish. Wow, how about that? It's really cold water, so this is good sport in the cold conditions, but it's really working the lures nice and subtle and using the cut down stuff. This is a super little rod, it really is. I'm delighted with it. Just a nice setup to play fish on, big and small. Oh, it's a lovely perch, this one. Ooh, that's a proper perch. Ooh. Nice big fish, beautiful colours. Classic late winter fish. Look at that. It's hard not to break into a whole string of superlatives when you see a perch in that sort of condition. Just look at the colours. Really, really vivid markings, and that's because we've had a spell of cold weather that's made the water go very clear, and
the vivid colours of the fish are really highlighted. Beautiful fish, look at that. Fantastic perch. I'm into something here that's just ripped a load of line off the drag. It's quite heavy fish. I mean, I've been fishing for perch and I can only assume that I've got a pike on, because this is a really fast moving fish. It's so angry. Normally in this cold water, they dog around a lot, but this fish is coming right at me at high speed. And I'm just a bit worried about pulling the hooks on it, so I've backed the drag off a touch. Must be a pike, surely. Well, the lure's come out of the net. This is a really fat pike, and it's a good 20 plus. It's a beautiful 7 pike. Well, look at that, pike just over 20 pounds. Real beauty, fat as anything, and beautiful markings, which is typical of these 7 pike. Look at the fins, they're absolutely beautifully coloured. They're almost tiger-like, and that is typical of these 7 fish. And then these lovely long bars along the flanks. Really nice looking pike.
Do now is blow about the only last bit of fishing I've got left for myself, so that you can all come down here and swamp it in your cheap little boats, knock the f*** out the predators.
Yeah.
Shall I do that? Is that what you, that's exactly what you want me to do? Okay. Take one. Well, today it's the maiden voyage of... No, it isn't the maiden voyage. Bollocks.
You are all I need, my Sarah. You gotta shake, rattle and roll. Shake, rattle and roll. Oh, you do shake, rattle and roll. Oh, baby, shake, rattle and roll. Oh, oh, shake, rattle and roll. Shift your rattle and roll.
Oh dear. To do with Martin Fowns. And apparently you've got 37 parrots. Imagine what that was like. Bum, 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 bum.
Do you have a favourite tune to sing when you're spinning, trolling and casting on winter's day?
No, I just vary it around a bit, really. Different tunes for different speeds of lure fishing. If I'm making a very aggressive jigging motion, I usually go for Auntie Mary had a canary up the leg of her drawers, when she farted down it darted. Da-da-da-da-da. I think the last line is actually during intercourse, but this is a family show, so we won't say it.
What about in a wheel within a wheel?
Well, that's when I'm having a bad day. It's all going on in my head, like, why am I not catching anything? Is it the water temperature? Is it just so I haven't got the right loading? Is it because I'm not relaxed enough or I'm in the wrong spot? I'm angry. Nice boat. Completely wasted on a river like this, of course, but there you are. bit like having a Formula One car on the M25, isn't it? Yeah, got him. Oh, I just struck it off.
The Ministry of Dyslexia is for people who can't spray their worms properly.